they do like it here. I mean, it's generally a good mix of dogs. Sometimes you get some aggressive ones, but generally it's a good mix, and there's so much space. You know, there's the one with, like, kind of the most space for them to run.
What is your name?
Daniel Maison. This is Gulliver. He's a Cocker Spaniel. He's turning 5 at the end of the summer, so he's about 4 and a half now. I'm here at least 4 or 5 times a week. We go on long walks, but this is the only place where he gets to run around off-leash, so. He actually is more of a people person than a doggy person. I come here more for me.
And has your dog ever gotten in a fight with another dog?
He's never initiated, but he's been the recipient of aggressive behavior, I would say. He likes sniffing, and other dogs don't always like to be sniffed, so. He keeps me outside, mandatory study breaks, and that kind of thing. I'm embarrassed to admit he does have 4 different sweaters, including a parka for the snow. I actually have a guinea pig named Leopold.
Do they get along?
They get along quite well, thank you. He's more scared of the guinea pig than the guinea pig is.
Oh, really?
And what is your name?
Kathy.
Kathy? What's your dog's name?
Jet. He's a cockapoo, which means he's half cocker spaniel and half poodle. Well, we just started coming here last week, so this is about the 3rd time we've been here. He makes instant friends with everyone and every creature.
Oh, he, you know, just like that.
Well, he kind of argued with that dog, but he's a really friendly dog.
Do you put clothing on him in the winter?
No. Sometimes I do. Yeah, once I dressed him up and took pictures of him. I put necklaces on him, and I put Kevin's police. He had a little police costume. I put that on him, and poor dog.
What's your name?
Caitlin.
Caitlin, and what are your dog's names?
Charlie and Milo. They're both he's both males, and they're both rescues, so we don't really know. They're both mixed breeds, I think. There's a dog, a little black, not puggle, but it's kind of similar, that he loves and plays with. Kingsley is his name, and there's a...
Bailey.
I don't know what kind of dog she is, but he loves her. And there's a wheaten terrier. He's definitely made a couple of friends, but he will seek them out if they're here. And we have a big kind of fat ginger cat, and Milo plays with that one sometimes, but they don't really pay attention to the others.
What do you think? What's your name?
Rich Newirth.
Rich, and what is your dog's name?
Nugget. Love Nugget. She's a mutt, I think. Chocolate Lab and Pit, some other things in there.
And how often do you guys visit the dog park?
At least twice a week, sometimes 3 or 4 times. I live in a building with a lot of dogs, so she sees some of them here and recognizes them back at the building and vice versa. But she has a blast here. She's great with smaller dogs. When she first started coming here with bigger dogs, she was a little afraid, and she'd play well sometimes, but every now and then there'd be a little melee. I did get her sort of like a little horse shawl type of thing, just a little blanket to put over her, because when it got really cold, she was shivering when I'd walk her to work, so I think she was very proud of it. And then for a short period of time when she went into heat, I had to put diapers on her. That was unpleasant for both of us.
Yeah, she's trying to eat the microphone. Yeah, that's always fun.
Oh. Whoops.
My name's Nora.
Nora, and what is your dog's name?
Smokey Titan. Smokey for short.
He likes your mic.
Yeah, he's a blue Great Dane. He's 2. I think he's done growing. Somebody said I should wait for, there might be another growth spurt, but I think he's pretty much maxed out. Yeah, well, we've taken him rafting in the Delaware Water Gap. Yeah. Yeah, and he actually wore a human life jacket, like an extra large, because he's got such a big rib cage. And we've taken him camping a whole bunch, and he loves to go to Newport, Rhode Island. And then, in the city, everywhere. He goes everywhere, Central Park, in a cab. They love him in cabs. In Bloomingdale's, all the stores, all, like, nice big retail stores.
They don't care?
No, most places don't care. If they don't have food, they don't care. Yeah. And then there's a couple other Great Danes that come here, too, that he really likes. Kaiser and Simone. And then, of course, all the other... He likes little dogs, but Chihuahuas usually run after him and try to beat him up. He's just big, you know, big love, big hugs, big poop. Larger breeds are better than smaller or medium-sized because they kind of poop out, you know, so they're kind of big couch potatoes. So after this long walk, he'll, like, sleep the rest of the night. So he's just a big cuddle bug. He's a big cuddle bug. Hi, Smokey.
Not the perfume that you wear. It's not the ribbons in your.